We will begin with a new chapter, that is the chapter 4, known as reproductive health. In this chapter, you will study about the reproductive health and the problems due to the ill reproductive health and strategies. And you will also study about the population explosion and birth control methods, as well as MTP, that is medical termination of pregnancy, and sexually transmitted diseases, as well as infertility. So you have already learned in your previous chapter, that is human reproductive system, about the various organs and the functions of different organs. Now, what is reproductive health? Actually, first of all, you must know the meaning of health. What is health? The health is the state of physical, mental and social well-being of a person. So health, or you can say the good health, is the state of physical, mental and social well-beingness of a person. And reproductive health includes aspects that ensure a responsible and safe reproductive life. So the reproductive health includes aspects that ensure a responsible and safe reproductive life. Now, what is reproductive health? It refers to healthy reproductive organs with normal functioning of healthy reproductive organs. And it also includes the emotional and social aspects of the reproduction. Then according to WHO, that means according to World Health Organization, reproductive health means a total well-being in all aspects of reproduction. That is physical, emotional, behavioral and social. I repeat, according to the WHO, the definition of reproductive health is a total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social. Then reproductive health implies that the people are able to have a responsible, satisfying and proper sex life, and they have the capability to reproduce and freedom to decide when and how often to do so. Then implicit in this are the rights of men and women to be informed of and to have access of safe, effective, affordable and acceptable methods of fertility regulation of their choice, and the right of access to appropriate health care services, and provide couples with the best chance of having a healthy infant. By the above definition, it is clear that a society with people having physically and functionally normal reproductive organs. So according to the WHO definition, it is clear that the people who are having physically and functionally normal reproductive organs and normal emotional and behavioral interaction among them, then all their sex related aspects might be called reproductively healthy. Now, why do we have to study reproductive health? Actually, reproductive health aims at providing awareness regarding the contraceptive or the birth control methods to both males and females. It also gives the ability to prevent the controlled sexually transmitted diseases. The sexually transmitted diseases are termed as STDs. So the people can have the controlled or ability to prevent the STDs if they are aware about the healthy reproductive life. Then it also helps the people to manage disorder related to the reproductive health. There are many disorders which are related with the reproductive health. So the people, those who are aware about them, they are able to manage and they are able to go for their cure also. So reproductive health, the problems and strategies, reproductive health, the problems and strategies. So India is one of the first countries that initiated number of programs to achieve total reproductive health. One is the family planning, another is the reproductive and child health care. And in the family planning method, India is this method or this program, it was initiated in 1951 at the national level, and it is periodically assessed and the new strategies are planned to make it successful. So one of its campaign is Hum Do Hamare Do, that is educating the people about the advantages of having a small family so that the parents can look after them very well and provide them necessities which are required to run their life smoothly. Now the reproductive and the child health care, which is also represented by an abbreviation called as RCH. This RCH is important. So here on the screen I am showing you the RCH in the top lines. This RCH programs include number of programs whose two main objectives is to bring awareness among the people about various reproductive related aspects and to provide facilities and support for building up a reproductive healthy society. So RCH, it creates awareness among the people about various reproduction related aspects and provides facilities as well as support them for building up a healthy reproductive society. So this way the strategies for successful implementation of program, they are a number of governmental and non-governmental agencies are involved in raising the awareness about reproduction related aspects through audiovisual aids. So through audiovisual aids, government and the non-government agencies, they provide the awareness about the reproductive health, and through the radios as well as the TV and the print media like newspapers and magazines. So they give so many advertisements as well as the so many small documentaries. They show it on the TV as well as they publish in the newspaper and the magazine, so that the people become aware about the various reproductive related aspects, whether having any disease in the reproductive organs or not. And then for proper dissemination of information, parents, close relatives, teachers and friends are also involved in this. Then sex education in schools is also introduced, and this is planned to provide right information to the young minds, just growing minds. They are not aware about the reproductive health. So the sex education in schools, it is planned to understand the reproductive organs and the reproductive health and the problems related with it. So the young minds, they are given the right information through the sex education, and to discourage the children in believing the myths and clear the misconception about the sex related aspects. So the sex education also provide the clear any misconception and related with the sexual problems. And it also provides proper knowledge about various sex-related aspects, proper information about reproductive organs, as well as the changes in the adolescence age and various changes related to it in the body, including physical and the hormonal changes. Because at the adolescent age, the children, they have physical as well as the hormonal changes in their body and the reproductive organs also. So due to the sex education provided in the school, it is means the children are aware about the good reproductive health. Then need for safe and hygienic sexual practices. Yes, the children at the growing age or the young children, they are not aware about the hygienic sexual practices. So it is the sex education in the school provide these all hygienic sexual practices, and they spread the types of they also help in making them aware about the spread of the sexually transmitted diseases. They also provide the information about the fast spreading diseases like STDs like AIDS, hepatitis B, etc. So another aim of this RCH, or the you can say the strategies for successful implementation of this program, that is targeting and educating the marriageable age groups and the couples, and that is importance of bringing up socially conscious healthy families of desired size, and the available birth control options, care of pregnant mother, postnatal care of the mother and the child, importance of the breastfeeding, and equal opportunities for male and the female child. So the people are made aware about the number of issues which I mentioned to you, and they can take different steps. They can understand the steps and can take the help of the programs implemented, and thus they can prevent them and build up a socially responsible and healthy society. So these issues are there, the problems due to uncontrolled population growth, social evils like sex abuse and sex related crimes, then drugs, alcohol and tobacco abuse. These are the number of issues on which the people are made aware. Then there is a support needed for successful implementation of the programs. So you can say for building up a healthy reproductive society, there is a need of a good support system like strong infrastructural facilities, professional expertise, material support of all kinds. So how the program can be helped? So the program, there are many ways by which these programs can be provided help. These programs are provided help by the medical assistance and care to the people in reproduction related problems like pregnancy, delivery, STDs, abortions, contraceptions, menstrual problems, infertility, etc. As well as the research work which provides an implementation of the better techniques and the new strategies from time to time, and they provide more efficient and care of the people. Care is provided to the people. Then there is a statutory ban on amniocentesis. This I mentioned in my previous lecture with you. What is amniocentesis? It is a medical technique to study chromosomal pattern of the fetus. Amniocentesis is a medical technique to study chromosomal pattern of the fetus or to determine the sex, to check the female feticide. So they go for this amniocentesis. Actually, it is the chromosomal pattern is to find out the abnormality. If any abnormal chromosome is there, then the such type of implantation can be stopped or it can be deleted. Then but in our country it is banned because they come to know about the sex of the child, and if it is a female child, they kill the female child in many states, or you can say in many places of our country. So awareness and implementation of the massive child immunization, that is this one is very, very important. when if the child is not if the parents are not aware about the immunization program, then the child is not given the immunization, and then the child after the birth suffers for many diseases. So this massive child immunization program, it is like the polio program, so that the parents make sure that the children are immunized at right time against the diseases. Similarly, there are many other vaccines also of different diseases, like tuberculosis, which is just provided. This vaccine is BCG. It is just given within 2-3 days after the birth of the child. That is termed as bacillus calamitic urine. So this way, massive child immunization program is also very, very important. So this amniocentesis and massive child immunization, as well as I told you, the for the successful implementation of the program, small infrastructural facilities and the professional expertise is required, as well as the material support and the awareness through the TV, or you can say the radio and the newspapers, all about the diseases which are caused in the reproductive organs. So they are provided awareness about all this, and they can protect themselves. So here I told you about the research work also. Researchers on various reproductive related areas, they are also encouraged by many government or the non-government. And here the new methods are there on this screen. They are to improve the existing ones. So this is the Saheli, that is oral contraceptive for the females, and developed by the scientists at the Central Drug Research Institute, CDRI, in Lucknow. That is just to make aware about the sex related matters, increased number of medically assisted deliveries and better postnatal care, leading to decreased maternal deaths and all that. Thank you.